So this is the project. This is an end project, so you can kind of get an idea of the big picture. It looks intense, and like maybe that would take forever. It does take a while, but I'm going to show you how to do it step by step to make it a lot easier, okay? So there's a couple different elements of art at play here. One is obviously the element of line. And if you notice, this line right here, the movement kind of all stems from that line. It gives it the illusion that these worm tunnels, whatever they are, kind of come up towards this point, and that's the highest point, the closest to the viewer, and then they go away, and even these ones get so small they kind of disappear underneath and in between. So it's kind of a neat effect. There's also a lot of value involved, which is another fancy way to say the shading. And I'll show you how to shade it to make it look like it's 3D and that it's kind of round. And then, so that we've got movement and we've got texture. It looks shiny and smooth. We've got line, all kinds of things going on here in value. So what you're gonna need for this project is a piece of paper and a pencil to start. That's pretty much it. For the coloring, I would either recommend colored pencils or crayons. You could probably use watercolor, but it would take you a lot longer. So I would stick with colored pencils or crayons. I wouldn't use oil pastels because it will smear like crazy. Okay? Here's another example to kind of show you. You can use all kinds of colors, but we gotta start at the beginning. So let's start at the very beginning. Okay, the first step is to put your paper horizontal, landscape style, and then you're going to attempt to kind of cut the space in half by using a wavy line. Not too many waves, maybe one or two waves in it, nothing crazy, although you could try crazy if you want. I'm gonna do that. You can start up here and go down, start down here and go up. You can have a couple humps in your wave, but it doesn't really matter as long as you've kind of got a wave. Okay? Step two. I want you to pick 8 points along that wave where you're actually gonna put a dot or a dash. I don't know why 8, but it seems to work out pretty well if you use 8, so I would say 8. They don't have to be equidistant. You can have some of them close together, some farther apart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? Some of them are further apart, some of them are equidistant. Okay, the next step. You need to connect the dots by using kind of a squashed arch. Almost like you're gonna draw like an eyelid or something like that. I wouldn't go over like 1/4 inch. This also kind of reminds me of like if you're drawing a little dinosaur, the little spines on a dinosaur's back. Like a cute dinosaur, not like a really mean dinosaur. Anyway, the next thing you're gonna do is pick one of them. I usually start with this one, but you can start with whichever one you like. And then we're gonna stack some more arcs on top of it. Now this is the part where some people get confused. We're not like drawing circles on top of it. We're stacking arcs on it, okay? And how do you do that? I start at the dot for the first one, go up about the same distance, and do another arc, okay? Then we're gonna do the same thing again, and I usually overlap the first line here for this second arc, so I'm staying the same width, and go up a little further, and come back down, and keep doing that. Now, if you want this to go wider, you're going to have to angle these lines out a little bit more each time. If you want them to go smaller, which seems to happen naturally for me, you bring the lines further in each time. So I'm going to start with going in, making it smaller. And you're going to find that some of these go straight, some of them tend to curve. It depends on you. I mean, it really, it's kind of like a freestyle thing where you just go for it. So mine kind of went off in the distance. And to me, this looks like a little gnome hat, or maybe like Maleficent's, one of her horns. Okay, here's the next important step. You gotta skip one and do the next one. So you're gonna draw one of these forms on every other hump and leave the ones blank in the middle for now. We'll get back to them. It seems to work best that way. So remember again, if you're having trouble with this, it's almost like you're drawing rainbows, okay, all the way off the page. I'm gonna make this one go a little bit wider if I can. So I'm gonna go back over this line and go out a little bit. You see how I angled it out just a smidge? I don't like how that one looks because it didn't really curve as much as I liked. We all make mistakes. Thank goodness for erasers. So now I'm going to keep going out as this path seems to curve out. And this is making it more look like more like a stalactite hanging from the ceiling. Stalactite is what you call the ones hanging from up high, because you hope they're tight so that they don't fall. Stalagmites are on the ground, so they, because you might trip over it if you're not careful. Hope that's, you remember that the next time you go caving, spelunking. Alright, this one's taking a while. I think I'm gonna, oops. Kind of go off into the distance here. Sometimes they look like a train that's going off into the distance. Whoop. Okay, so I'm still skipping every other one. And I'll show you why in a second, but just trust me for now. Okay, now we have these natural parameters for our next lines. So we can literally just take the arc from here to the ear and just give it a little curve, and we don't have to worry about like keeping it in line with the previous arch. However, I'm not sure that I like how this one goes out. So what I might do is have this one kind of go in and then add another one in the middle. We'll see. But now you can fill in all the empty ones, okay? And I'm probably going to start here because I'm not really sure what I want to do yet. But I'm kind of looking to see. All of yours are going to look different. So that one's too big. No worries if yours doesn't look close to mine, okay? Huh? I went ahead and kept going all the way out, and it looks just fine, so I'm going to go with that. This looks like another little gnome hat to me. Or another Maleficent curve to her. Whoop, there we go. And then fill this one in. See if I can make this look better without. There we go. Ta-da! So here we are. We have half of it done. So how do we do the other half? I will tell you. We flip it. Okay? And then you're going to pretend like this end never even happened. And we're starting at the beginning by connecting the dots with arcs. Okay? So go ahead and connect your dots. It's important that the arches on this side are going the opposite direction of the ones you just did. So these are aiming that way and these are aiming that way. That gives the illusion later that the wormholes are coming up towards you and then going away. And then the ones on the end, I don't know if I told you this before, but you can kind of just assume that they would come over here somewhere and hit another dot, okay? Now, same thing, just pick one, start with it, and then you're going to fill every other one in, every other tower. Oopsie. Make this one go bigger. And then skip. Okay, I'm going to do something special with this one right here because it's something I've seen a lot of students do, and so I want you to know how to handle it if it happens, okay? So sometimes we go small too early, and then it's like you can't go any smaller at some point. So we're here. So how do you deal with that, with all this space? How do you attack that? I'll show you in a minute. Keep that thought. Let's finish our every other one first. Oopsie. And then we'll go over it. I'm making my... One of my students said it looks like pancakes. A stack of pancakes. I'm making my stack too tall. Okay. So here's where we're at. Where we're at. And now we gotta fill them up. So I'm gonna start with the easy ones over here. We know that all we have to do here is just connect the sides now with arches that are about the same size. Looks like a giant rainbow. Okay, so what do we do here? I would probably start with, just pick one to start with. I'm gonna start with the smaller one. And then for me, the easiest way to do is kind of pretend this line is still going in this path and aim that general direction while you're continuing. I hope that makes sense. Okay. So now I have all this space I can fill with this guy. I can make a giant one. Or I could add other ones in, but I think I'm going to go for it because I don't have one yet that's giant, like that takes up half the page like this one. This is a big one. That is going to take a lot of coloring. Cool. I like how that turned out. Okay, and then fill in the last one. Okay, so that one's done. Don't worry if it takes you a little bit longer to get that done. I've done this lots of times recently, explaining it to other classes. See? Ooh, this is one of my favorite ones. Can't wait to do that one. Anyway, so it's okay. Now we gotta decide how we're gonna color this baby. I would recommend you alternate colors. You could, really, you could make it solid all the way down if you wanted a solid color and it would still look 3D. I think something about alternating colors just makes it look cooler. And so, that being said, you can pick your two favorite colors, you can pick contrasting colors, you can do, like, if I wanted to, I could have done this whole thing, just pink and blue, the whole thing. But, I don't know, these other colors I just felt like adding, just for some interest. So, it's kind of up to you. You can use your favorite colors, your favorite sports team colors. I was kind of going for a Halloween candy looking theme here that I haven't finished yet. I have another one I wanted to show you that's red, white, and blue. I didn't know how to do white. So I went in and I tried to shade it just with a pencil and I didn't really like how it looked, so I left the white blank. And even if you leave one solid white, solid blank, and you don't, solid black I mean, and you don't shade it, I think it still looks 3D because of these. So like maybe this is a matte finish and this is a shiny finish. I don't know, but I think it looks cool that way too. So those are just some ideas. You can use a whole rainbow of colors if you want to. I doesn't really matter. It's up to you. I chose to use three colors in this one and two colors in this one. So, what am I going to do this time? That's the question, Jones. Actually, I might just work on finishing this one. Okay? I'm going to turn it sideways so I can kind of give you a better idea of how this is going to work. Alright, so Halloween colors that I'm going to stick with. I'm going to probably make this one purple and green and black again because I like how that turned out. So, here's my green. Ooh, is it the same color I used before? Yep. And here's my purple and my black. Here's my black. Here's my purple. Probably gonna need a pencil sharpener if you don't have one. I probably should have said that at the beginning because you're gonna need to sharpen a lot of pencils in this process. Okay? Alright, I'm gonna start with purple and show you how this shading works. Essentially, what you're gonna do is towards the sides of each form, you're gonna do it super dark, okay? As dark as you can. And then you're going to gradually let off and do it lighter towards the middle, and then you're going to leave the middle white. Don't color anything in the middle. So, that gives it the illusion of being shiny, the way that cylinders, like say a Coke can or something, is in the sunshine and it hits or a light's pointed at it, then it's super shiny and it reflects that light back. So it gives it the illusion of being shiny, okay? So what am I talking about? What do I even mean? So I start in the corner, pretty dark like that. Opposite corner, pretty dark like that. And then go back and do it a little bit lighter, like a medium. Okay? And then I might go one more layer of an even lighter shade. Something like that. Okay? Gives it the illusion of being shiny, don't you know? So, then I go back, and I'm gonna do the same thing with my next color. I'm gonna just use two colors on this one. I might skip the black, although I like that one a lot. Not sure what I wanna do. Well, just for the heck of it, we're just gonna do purple and green on this side. Now, if you accidentally color in the white spot that's meant to be white, always go back with an eraser and kind of make sure you line it up. You see how it's white here, but it kind of curves this way and then back that way? Not hard to see. So I might take my pencil and just erase some of that so it lines up better. So since I'm doing every other one, what I'll probably do is I'll go ahead and just do all the purple, and then I'll put my purple away, and then I'll do all the green. So it's easier on my brain. It's up to you how you want to do it, though. Like I said, it's your picture, so you can pick just two colors, you can pick just... I would pick at least two colors. You can do three colors, you can, as many colors as you want. You can alternate colors, you can make them all the same set of colors. And this may take you a while. The first one I showed you guys, I did that one while watching the first season of Julie and the Phantoms. Watch the whole thing. I'm not obsessed. Maybe a little bit. you haven't seen that show. Really good music, in my opinion. I don't know what kind of music you like, but it's like a combination of pop, R&B, and old school 90s rock, all in one. Songs get stuck in my head. So if I start humming, I'm sorry, I can't help it. See, I already need to sharpen that pencil. They kind of look like fun LuLaRoe leggings, too, or like Wicked Witch knee-high socks from the Wicked Witch, from the Wicked Witch of the West. Good song. Called Stand Tall. Love that one. So at some point it's gonna get really small down here. So I kind of just hit on the edges and bring it in just a little bit. Not too worried about it being exactly, because I mean, let's be honest, you can't really, once you get that small. Anyway, oh, it's kind of neat how it got smaller and then got bigger again at the end. I like that. It gives the illusion of getting closer and farther away and closer, which is the goal. Okay, neon green. Let's see what you got. If I have a dark green, it might be cool to do just a dark green and a light green one too. That would look very witchy from Halloween. I was trying to think and discuss with my students this week why these colors, why do I associate these with Halloween? I realized it's probably because these are really fall colors. This one's like candy corn, but you know, purples, golds, reds, oranges. Those are fall colors. Halloween happens during the fall. It's looking cool. I love that green. I want to talk to you guys about this cool website called Artsonia. A-R-T-S-O-N-I-A. Now, Artsonia is an online art portfolio that you can use K-12, pre-K-12 really, because my kids are on there that are not in school yet. You upload your artwork to this page. And only you, your parents, and your teacher can see this artwork. Unless you get your parents give you permission to share it publicly, and then, when that happens, everyone can see your artwork in the world if you want. So, I mean, it's not like out there obvious, but if you want to go to Maxwell's webpage, or Des Moines' webpage, or whoever, whichever school you belong to's webpage, you can just search the public ones. And sometimes they do contests every week. Artsonia chooses an artist of the week from every age group. Anyway, so your art can be put into competitions across the U.S. and you could win some things. It's also a nice place to keep all your artwork in one spot in case you're an artist and you want to have a portfolio for people to look at. Like if you're getting ready to go to college and apply for schools and stuff. There we go. It's looking pretty neat, right? Well, I think it's looking pretty neat. Maybe I'll just do just an orange and black one next. That'd be kind of cool. Where's my orange, though? I feel like I lost my orange. Is this orange? I don't know. Yeah. It's late at my house, so I'm running low on my black. So I'll do one more with you, and then I'm going to speed it up so you don't have to sit here and watch the whole thing again with me, and you don't have to listen to me jabber. Sharpen a pencil. That one kind of looks cool, just plain orange, to be honest. I'm gonna do this actually. It's like a different set of muscles to do each side. So I'm gonna do this side first. Give my hand a little rest, and then go on to the next side. There we go. My hand hurts after a while. So don't feel like you have to do this in one sitting. I feel like that's important to say right now. Because it'll probably give you a hand cramp. But, like, if you're relaxing and listening to music or something, or you're bored later, you could finish it. Because it's going to take more than one class period if you really wanted to do a good job. I've learned. hope yours is turning out good. If you're having trouble with the shading, just remember super dark, medium dark, really light, and then white, white in the middle. That white, white with nothing there is what gives it the illusion of being super shiny. Oh, I feel like I need to maybe go a little bit further in with mine. Ooh, that one turned out neat. We're getting there, folks. I really kind of like those two. So I think I might do... Oh, I don't know. I'm not sure what I want to do here. I'm sure I'm going to do another one like this. Can we handle this colored pencils? Might have to get some more colored pencils after this. Ouchie. Definitely should do like an orange and purple right here, probably. Or another one like that. Maybe we'll go orange and purple. Excuse me. Ugh, allergies are bugging me right now. Hooray, fall. thought that was a hair, but it's not. It's just a piece that needs to be erased. Hallelujah! Isn't shading amazing? All we're doing is shading, and it's making it look 3D. It's like it's jumping off the page. Shade is important in art. Bum, bum, bum. Oops. Okay. Ooh. My hand hurts. Count on myself. Music and art go hand in hand for me. Sharpen my pencil. Now, at the end of this, I'd like to show you kind of a twist of how you could change this up a little bit if you want to. I don't know if any of you guys like gnomes, but I appreciate the gnome craze. I think they're cute, and my sister keeps sending me gnomes made out of, like, fabric and stuff like that. They're super cute. Anyway, because this project reminds me of gnomes, I started drawing some that had gnomes hidden in them. Not really hidden, I mean you can tell it's a gnome. But I'm going to show you what that might look like in case you're going to do the gnome option. Not that one. Ah. See? Little towers kind of look like gnomes with little beards. They're so cute. So, you could easily make like one of these into a gnome hat if you wanted to. I'm gonna do a whole family of gnomes. I'm gonna keep finishing this guy. I'm almost done. I think we definitely need green again on this side. I like this green one. So I'm gonna do that one. Oops, I just messed it up. I was gonna do three colors. That's fine. Maybe I'll do green and black so it's not exactly the same. We'll do black. Side one's done. I like this one, so I'm gonna do one like that. And I'll do a purple one. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know what I wanna do. So many choices. I'm probably gonna regret this, but it's fine. Let's just do it. All right, Jones. It's not what I wanted to do again. I'm trying to do that one, and I keep forgetting. What will go good here? Yellow and black. Kind of like appears that that's might be my option. Oh man. I don't want to do orange and black because I already have that one. Do green or should I do yellow? That's the question. Okay, I don't even know what else I want to do here. I probably should do yellow. Right. I think this is the yellow I used. Yep. I'm lining up yellow. It's like a bee. last one. I'm going to do like a green and purple right here, I think. And green, last one. I'm so excited that I get to finish this with you guys. See, here we go. I think I'm done. Woohoo! Boom. There you have it. So, they look like worms to me. They look like worms to me. Let's see if I can find the other one I did. So you have some context for this situation. Okay, so then you can do every other one, you can do them all the same color scheme, you can change it up like crazy and have them all be different. You could make them gnomes if you want. You could make them all the same color scheme, so like pink and blue, pink and blue, pink and blue, pink and blue. It's up to you. But I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope you have fun, and I hope you can impress your friends and family with this op art video. See you later. Bye.